As the offering bag is going around, I'd like to make known to you that we will be having a mission trip to Thailand from the 26th to the 28th of March. So if you are able to join us, please mark down the dates for this year's mission trip to Thailand. All right, we will probably depart on a Sunday, which is the 24th of March, all the way to 29th of March. All right, so we will be going to Chonburi, Thailand, to conduct a character camp for the local children. So if you'd like to join us, please make sure that you find out more information as we roll it out in the coming weeks. For those of you who have given your offering, please prepare your hearts for the Holy Communion. Father, we praise you and we thank you that you have established a new covenant through the blood of Jesus Christ. Thank you that, Father, you are our covenant partner. We thank you for the body that was broken for us. Thank you for the blood that was shed for us for the forgiveness of our sin. We thank you that, Father, through this covenant that you have promised to journey with us on a daily basis. We give you praise and thanks for your everlasting love. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you're here with us for the first time, please take note that ICS practice an open table, which means we're welcome to partake of the Holy Communion with us as long as you're a believer of Jesus Christ. But one thing we ask of you, that is to hold on to the elements so that we can partake of it together. For those of you who are not a believer, may I ask that you pass the element to the next person. For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when they had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
他们吃的时候，耶稣拿起饼来，祝了福，就给他们，你们拿着吃，这是我的身体。
In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes."
用拿起杯来祝谢了，给他们，他们都喝了。耶稣说：“这是我立约的血，为多人流出来的。我实在告诉你们，我不再喝这葡萄汁，一直到我神国所到来的那日子。”I'd
like to begin this morning sermon with a testimony.
我今天讲到呢，想要从一个见证的分享来开始。
I was on a flight back from a mission trip some 20 years ago.
在20年前呢，我从一个旅程，在坐一个飞机回来。
So we were all seated together.
我们所去的同伴都一起坐在。
And this church members was just asking me regarding how to seek the will of God.
有一位弟兄呢，就是在问我如何去寻求神的旨意呢。
Because he has been asked to be posted to Beijing.
当时这个公司就把他派到北京。
And he was struggling to whether to accept the posting to Beijing or to stay in Singapore.
当时他心里非常挣扎，到底是应着公司去北京呢，还是留在新加坡呢？
It was a Fortune 500 company.
它是一个福布斯榜500前500的公司。
He told me that he was struggling because if he were to take the posting, he will leave the comfort of home.
他如果是拿了这个 offer 去北京的话，他就心里非常挣扎，因为他舒舒服服的日子就要离开他了。
Please remember that 67% of the world population do not like changes.
请大家记住，其实有世界人口的67%呢，都不喜欢做出任何改变。
The person was struggling because if he chose to leave Singapore for Beijing, he would lose a lot of money.
他心里非常挣扎，他若是新加坡搬到北京，他其实会失去很多的钱财。
He just bought a new car.
他刚刚在新加坡买了一个新车。
And every one of us know when you buy a new car, you know, within the first year you lose 20%.
那大家也知道，如果你买了新车的第一年，你即使就会失去20%的价值。
And he was losing about probably 200,000 RMB.
他可能会失去了20万人民币所等值的价值。
So I was telling him, why don't you seek the face of God?
所以我当时就告诉这位弟兄，你为什么不寻求神的面呢？
It is important to walk in obedience.
因为这我们走在顺服的道路上是非常重要的。
And journal what the Lord is speaking to you.
而且是要记住写下神对我们所说的话语。
As I've encouraged you to journal last Sunday.
所以我也像上周日与大家鼓励的一样。
To pick up this book.
请大家去拿到这本。 这个记录
to journal with the Lord. I said, why don't you read 4 chapters of Old Testament every day and 2 chapters of New Testament every day?
那我鼓励这位弟兄说，你应该读四章的旧约和两章的新约，并且去记下神对你所说的话。
God will speak to you either to stay or to leave.
所以神会告诉你，你到底是要在新加坡还是要去北京的。
So this person sought the Lord.
所以他去寻求了神的面。
And it was very clear that the Lord asked the person to leave the comfort zone and to go to Beijing.
所以他祷告之后非常清楚的是，神告诉他，他要离开新加坡去北京。
And a few months later.
在过去几个月之后。
He realized that the department that he worked for was completely closed.
他听到一个消息，就是他所工作的那个部门就被关闭了。
If he had stayed, he would have lost his job.
如果他当时坚持在新加坡工作的话，他会失去他的工作。
Praise the Lord that he obeyed the will of God.
感谢赞美神，这位弟兄是顺服了神的旨意的。
There's a huge difference in lifestyle, especially when God is with us and when we are living our lives apart from God's plan.
当神与我们同在时，和当我们生活脱离神的计划的时候，生活方式有巨大的差异。
I have witnessed many people who live miserably because they are holding on to their lives instead of surrendering it to God.
我见过许多人呢，过着悲惨的生活，因为他们紧紧抓住自己的生命，不愿意降服于神。
In fact, it will make or break a man if we are living our lives with or without God's blessing.
事实上，我们生命中是否活在神的祝福里，将决定一个人的成败。
We have read in the Bible how wise leaders sought the presence of God and allow God to lead them by abiding in God.
我们在圣经中读到聪明的领袖如何寻求神的同在，并通过常住在神里面来神来用神来带领他们。
In fact, there are some non-negotiables if you want to walk by faith in God, and you'll be covered in this sermon today.
事实上呢，我们若要凭对神信心行事，那么有些事是不能学的。今天的讲道将涵盖这些内容。
Turn with me to Exodus chapter 33, verse 4 to 6 and verse 12 to 18.
让我们来一起诵读一下出埃及记33章4到6节12到18节。
And when the people heard this bad news, they mourned and no one put on his ornaments. For the Lord has said to Moses, Say to the children of Israel, You are stiff-necked people, I come upinto your midst in one moment and consume you. Now therefore take off your ornaments that I may know what to do with you. So the children of Israel stripped themselves of their ornaments by Mount Horeb. Verse 12. Then Moses said to the Lord, See, you say to me, bring up these people, but you have not let me know whom you will send with me. Yet you have said, Now I know you by name and you have also found grace in my sight. Now therefore I pray, if I have found grace in your sight, show me now your way that I may know youAnd I may find grace in your sight. And consider that this nation is your people. And he said, My presence will go with you, and I will give you rest. Then he said to him, If your presence does not go with us, do not bring us up from here. For how then will it be known that your people and I have found grace in your sight, except you go with us? So we shall be separate, your people and I, from all the people who are upon the face of the earth. So the Lord said to Moses, I will also do this thing that you have spoken, for you have found grace.In my sight, and I know you by name. And he said, "Please show me your glory."
百姓听见这凶信，就悲哀，也没有人佩戴装饰。耶和华对摩西说：“你告诉以色列人说，耶和华说，你们是应着景象的百姓。我若一霎时就临到你们中间，必灭绝你们。现在你们要把身上的装饰摘下来，使我可以知道怎样待你们。以色列人从何烈山，从住何烈山以后，就把身上的装饰摘得干净。摩西对耶和华说：你吩咐我说将这百姓领上去，却没有叫我知道你要打发谁与我同去，只说我按时你的名。”认识你，你在我眼前也蒙了恩。我如今若在你眼前蒙恩，求你将你的道指示我，使我可以认识你，好在你眼前蒙恩。求你想到这民是你的民。耶和华说：“我必亲自和你同去，使你得安息。”摩西说：“你若不亲自和我同去，就不要把我们从这里领上去。人在何事上得以知道我和你的百姓在你的眼前蒙恩呢？岂不是因你与我们同去，使我和你的百姓在地上万民有分别吗？”耶和华对摩西说：“这所求的我也要行，因为你在我眼前蒙了恩，并且我按你的名认识你。”摩西说：“求你显出你的荣耀给我看。”
In this passage, we are faced with a people who have just left the land of slavery in Egypt, and they do not know God.
这段经文呢，我们看到一群刚离开埃及之地的为奴之家的人，他们并不认识神。
God gave them the Ten Commandments so that they know that God is a holy God and they are sinful people.
神借着摩西赐给他们的十诫呢，使他们知道什么样的是罪，又知道是神是圣洁的神。
In fact, even though they have left Egypt physically, but their heart is still in Egypt because they are used to their lifestyle despite of being slaves in the land.
尽管他们的身体已经离开了埃及，但他们的心仍在埃及，因为他们已经习惯了埃及地的各种生活方式。
They were not thankful for the manna and the quails provided for them supernaturally on a daily basis.
他们并不感恩每天有超自然的玛纳和鹌鹑提供给他们。
The thing is, people do not change even though we live in a different era.
问题是呢，即使我们生活在非常不同的时代，人们还是没有改变。
There's a parallel between the Israelites leaving Egypt, which was a place of slavery and possessing the promised land, and us living a lifestyle of sin to possess the abundant life in Christ.
以色列人离开埃及地，这个为奴之家，并拥有这个应许之地，与我们离开罪恶的生活方式，拥有基督里丰盛的生命之间是有相似之处的。
The Israelites had to abide by the law to enjoy the blessing and the protection of God.
以色列人呢，必须遵守律法才能够享受神的祝福。
Likewise, we must abide in Christ and in His Word to have our prayers answered and be blessed holistically.
同样呢，我们必须常在基督和他的话语里面，我们祷告才能被成就和得到全面的祝福。
The key lies in our obedience, even though God has good plan, purpose, and intentions for us.
尽管神对我们有美好的计划、旨意和意念，但重点是我们要顺服。
We can be a stubborn people.
我们可以是非常顽梗的。
God always has a good plan for us.
神总是对我们有美好的计划。
He has good thoughts for us.
他也有好的想法给我们。
God is a good God.
因为他是一个良善的神。
If you are to read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, realize that He is definitely a good God.
如果你从圣经的创世纪读到启示录的话，你就是会发现他是一位良善的神。
Meanwhile, we need to know that He has created us to be a free moral agent with the ability to choose either to submit.Or rebel against him.
与此同时呢，神创造我们是一个有自由意志的个体，有能力去选择顺服他，或者是违背他。
Of course, we are in a better condition as compared to the Old Testament saints because we are born again, we are a new creation, and we have the nature of God in us and empowered by the Holy Spirit.
当然了，与旧约中的圣徒相比，我们要处境好很多，因为我们重生了，是一个新造的人，我们里面有神的本性，并被圣灵赋予了能力。
The Old Testament saints.Was dominated by sin and under the control of the evil one, but still have a choice to choose to follow God or to rebel against God.
旧约当中的圣徒虽然被罪所辖制的，活在恶者的掌控下，但他们仍然可以选择跟随神，或者是不跟随神。
For us, we still need to yield to the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus, even though we are saved, born again, and has the nature of God in us.
即使我们已经得救了、重生了，并有神的性情在我们里面，但是我们仍然需要顺服耶稣基督赐的我们生命的灵。
If not, we are just as stiff-necked and difficult to deal with like the Israelites in Moses' era.
否则呢，我们就会像摩西时代的以色列一样，硬着颈项，难以管教。
Verse 5 and verse 6 of the main text says, For the Lord has said to Moses, Say to the children of Israel, You are a stiff-necked people. I could come up into your midst.In one moment and consume you. Now therefore take off your ornaments that I may know what to do with you. So the children of Israel stripped themselves of their ornaments by Mount Horeb.
在五到六节讲到，耶和华对摩西说：“你告诉以色列人说，耶和华说，你们是应着景象的百姓。我若一霎时间临到你们中间，必灭绝你们。现在你们要把身上的装饰摘下来，使我可以知道怎么待你们。”以色列人从往何烈山以后，就把身上的装饰撇得干净。
The word stiff neck is also translated as obstinate, and it means
应着景象的这个词呢，翻译为顽固，它的意思是
obstinate means crochet.According to Strong Concordance, it means hard, cruel, severe, obstinate, difficult, fierce, intense, vehement, stubborn, stiff neck, rigorous.
这个顽固是什么意思呢？是艰难的、残酷的、极为恶劣的、坚固的、困难的、严厉的、凶猛的、激烈的、猛烈的、顽梗的、冥顽不灵的、应着景象和严苛的。
I'm sure you have met people whom you have told them not to do it, but yet they continue doing it.
我相信大家在生活当中碰到一些人，你告诉他不要这么做，他还是这么做。
That's being stiff-necked.
这个就是硬着颈项
的。That's being obstinate.
这个就是顽固的。
I've met many of such people.
我遇到了 这种人太多了。
Sin is basically self-centeredness and the desire to live independent of God.
最基本上是以自我为中心，渴望脱离神的一个生
活。We are resistant towards having to be told what to do.
我们不愿意被别人告诉我们该做什么。
Let me tell you, it's not a teenager thing.
我想告诉大家，这可不是一个青少年的问题。
It is a human thing.
这是一个人类的问题。
We do not like to be told what to do.
因为我们不喜欢被人告知我们做什么。
We are stubborn and not open to advice of others because we think that we know more than others.
我们非常固执，不愿意接受别人的建议，因为我们觉得我们比别人懂得还要多。
We are very intense in our ways. We want our rights, privileges, and freedom to do whatever we want, whenever we want, with whomever we want.
当我们想到自己的权利、特权、自由，去随时随地和我们想要的人一起做任何事情。
We want everything to be done our way.
因为我们想要用自己的方法去做事情。
Sometimes.Or not sometimes, many times.
经常
we tell God how to answer our prayers.
我们告诉神，神你以这种方式来回答我的祷告吧。
We tell God what we want.
我们告诉神我想要什么。
And we get frustrated because God does not answer us according to what we want.
我们会感到常常感到疲惫，就是神没有按照我们的方式去应许我们的祷告。
It is not what we want.
这个并不是我想要什么。
It is what God wants.
应该是去想神要我们做什么。
What does God want for our life?
神在我们的人生当中想要实现什么。
Sometimes it's also a protection not to be promoted.
常常是神是向你施加的保护，如果是你没有被升职的话。
Because he knows everything.
因为他是无所不知。
Just like the person.
就像我刚才举的那位弟兄的
例子。If God tells you to go to another country.
如果神告诉你搬到另外一个国家。
Go!
去吧
Don't stay.
不要留下来
God had a very good plan for his people in the Old Testament. However, they need to be abide by the covenant.
神在旧约当中，他的百姓有一个非常好的计划，但是他们需要遵守这个盟约。
The Mosaic covenant is a conditional covenant, which means if they were to obey the law, blessing will come upon them. If they violate the law, all the curses.Will come upon them.
摩西之约呢是一个有条件的约，他们遵守律法的时候就会得到祝福，他们违背这个律法的时候就会得到诅咒。
God has to judge. God has to operate in this way because He is holy, just, and righteous.
神必须这样做，因为他是圣洁、公正和公义的。
His holiness is of a very different standard from all of us because we tend to be more tolerant and compromised with sin.
他的圣洁与我们所有人的标准是不同的，因为我们往往更容易犯罪和对之妥协。
God has made it very clear to all these people regarding His expectation from them.
神已经向所有的百姓非常清楚地表明他对他们的盼望。
Exodus chapter 20 verse 2 to 5 says, "I'm the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself a calf image, any likeness of anything in heaven above that is on the earth beneath that is the water under the earth. You shall not bow down to them nor serve them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me.
出埃及记二十章第二到五节，我是耶和华你的神，曾在你埃及地为奴之家领出来。除我以外，你不可有别的神，不可为自己雕刻偶像，也不可做什么形象，仿佛上天、下地和地底下、水中和百物，不可跪拜那些像，也不可侍奉他，因为我耶和华你的神是祭邪的神，恨我的，我必追讨他的罪。自父其子直到三四代。
Moses was away from the crowd to be in the presence of God, and the people got impatient.
摩西离开群众去见神，百姓就不耐烦了。
Aaron blatantly asked the people to give up their jewelry, melted it, and molded a golden calf, and built an altar to worship it.
亚伦呢，公然就会要求百姓交出金环，然后把它融化之后铸成牛犊，然后去筑坛去供奉它。
They wanted something to be created so that they can see it, worship it.Since they can't see nor know God,
因为他们不认识神，也没有见过神，所以他们要制造一些他们能看到的东西来去侍奉。
They were very difficult people to deal with.
他们是一群非常难管教的。
It is an outright violation of what the Lord had instructed them not to do in the Ten Commandments.
这完全违背了神在十诫当中指示他们不要做的事情。
God had clearly revealed to them that He is God who brought them out of the land of Egypt, and He is a jealous God.
神已经清楚地向他们启示，他是领他们。出埃及地的神和他是祭邪的神。
There are consequences for violating the law of Moses, which is an instruction from God.
背弃神而的摩西律法是需要承担后 果的。
Likewise, in the New Testament, we will face the consequences of our sowing into the flesh and not walking in the Spirit.
同样，我们在新约当中也需要面对对着情欲撒种的，而不是顺着圣灵行事的后果。
The only difference between the Old Testament Israelites and us is we have the empowerment of the Holy Spirit to reign in life by choosing to yield and walk in the Spirit.
旧约当中，以色列人和我们之间唯一的区别是我们有圣灵赋予的能力，来在生命当中做王和能靠圣灵行事。
Unfortunately, people in postmodernism will be very liberal in their ways and will demand what they think is right rather than doing what is right.
不幸的是呢，是后现代主义的人行事方式非常的自由，他们要求做他们认为正确的事，而不是做正确的事。
2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1 to 5 says.But know this, that in the last days, perilous times will come, for men will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, unloving, unforgiving, slanderers, without self-control, brutal, despisers of good, traitors, headstrong, haughty, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power, and from such people, turn away.
提摩太后书三章一到五节，你该知道末世必有危险的日子来到，因为那时人要专顾自己，贪爱钱财，自夸狂傲，谤读，违背父母，忘恩负义，心不圣洁，无亲情，不解怨，好说谗言，不能自约，性情暴躁，不爱良善，卖主卖友，任意妄为，自高自大，爱宴乐，不爱神，有敬虔的外貌，却违背了敬虔的实意，这等人你要躲开。
We might not be worshipping a golden calf at home.
我们可能并不是在敬拜一个金牛犊在家里。
We might be Christians.
我们还是个基督徒。
But you might be the golden calf yourself.
但有可能你自己就是那个金牛犊。
You are Christian.
你是个基督徒。
But you're still running your own life.
但是你会在你的人生当中自己做主。
Christianity is just an insurance for you to go to heaven.
基督教呢，成为了你一个保险，就是能够去天堂的一个保险。
Doesn't this scripture describe what is happening in society today?
你不觉得我们刚才读的这个经文就是现今发生的一些事情
吗？ We are also witnessing some of this behavior in church. We are blatantly honest with ourselves.
那如果我们经常在教会里也能看到这些行动。
Some of us have seen the most brutal church politics that has caused Christians to devour one another through words and legal actions.
我们中的一些人呢，确实亲眼目睹了最惭愧的教会政治，基督徒用言语和法律相互的互相撕咬。
Religious Christian to go to church without giving up our rights nor live a surrendered life to God.
我们可以是一名虔诚的基督徒去教会，但是没有舍弃我们的权利，也不过着降服于神的生命。
You know, when we seek the will of God,
当我们去寻求神的旨意的时候
，we have to die to ourselves.
那么我们应该对自己而死。
Saying, God, not my will, Lord.
不是按照我自己的意。
Your will be done.
而是按照你自己的你的。
So when we seek the will of God,
所以当我们去寻求神的旨意时
，we do not have a preconceived answer.In regards to our prayers,
我们不应该有已经自己心中的一个答案。
We come before God and say, God, you tell me what you want me to do.
我们走到神面前，告诉神说，神，请你告诉我，你想要在我人生成就什么。
That's what it means to live a surrendered life.
这个就是降服于神的生命。
We can be very carnal in our thinking, our ways of doing things, and the lifestyle is no different from the people in the world.
我们在经常当中，我们可以过着肉体的生活，就像世人当中完全一样。
There will be Christians who will be haughty, full of themselves, belittling others, headstrong, and lovers of the world.
很多人就是只有自己看清别人，任意妄为和贪爱世界。
We can be easily offended by others' remarks and actions.
我们很容易被别人的言行所冒犯。
We tend to slander others in defense of ourselves, brutal in our treatment toward those who have wronged us.
我们喜欢诽谤他人来为自己辩护，残忍地对待那些冤枉我们的人。
Idolatry need not be a molded or carved image.
那些偶像并不一定是铸造的像。
It can be money.
这个很有可能是钱财。
We can idolize money.
这个很有可能我们把钱财当作偶像。
We might even idolize ourselves, just as the scripture says, lovers of themselves.
就像我们经文当中说的，我们爱自己就把自己当成了一个偶像。
Jesus will not be the Lord of our lives when we idolize ourselves. Then we will do what we feel good to do without regards to what the scripture or God thinks about it.
我们就不会去想圣经当中告诉我们什么，我们就会按照自己的意志而活。
It is very subtle. It comes out of our conversation, the decision that we make, and the lifestyle that we lead.
这个就是一个非常细微的差异，就是我们会行在我们生活当中的差异。
Galatians chapter 6 verse 7 and 8 says, Do not be deceived, God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. For he who sows to the flesh will of the flesh reap corruption, and he who sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap everlasting life.
加拉太书6章第7到8节，不要自欺，神是轻慢不得的。人种的是什么，收的也是什么。顺着情欲撒种的，必情欲收败坏；顺着圣灵撒种的，必从圣灵收永生。
So let me give you the definition of the flesh.
我想与大家分享什么叫情欲。
The flesh is the sum of appetites, desires, wishes, and needs, which purpose is the satisfaction of self, everything in our life that lives independently from God and does not bow to God.
情欲的定义呢，就是肉体是食欲，欲望和需要的各种总和，其目的是满足自我，是任何在我们生命中想要脱离神而活而不敬拜神的事情。
There's always a choice that we need to make in our lives.
我们常常在人生当中要做出一个选择。
We can either choose to walk in God's way.
我们或者是可以去行在神的旨意
上。God's values and principles.
也就是神的旨意和他的教导。
God's plan and purposes.
和他的目的和他的计划。
Or we choose our own way.
或者是呢，我们去选择自己的道路。
Independent of God.
也就是独立于神。
And we will reap the consequences of both decisions.
那么我们就会得到相应的结果。
Let me give you one example.
我想给大家举个例子。
2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 14 to 15 says, Do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with lawlessness? And what communion has light with darkness? For what accord has Christ with Belial? And what part has a believer with an unbeliever?
哥林多后书六章十四到十五节，你们和不信的原不相配，不要同负一轭。义和不义有什么相交呢？光明和黑暗有什么相通呢？基督和比列有什么相合呢？信主和不信主的有什么相干呢？
If someone is a believer and single,chooses to befriend and marry an unbeliever, then the person must face the consequences of the challenges in the marriage.
如果某人是单身的信徒而选择与不信主的人交往并结婚的话，那么这个人必须承担婚姻中的有挑战的后果。
Lawlessness means the person wants to have nothing to do with God nor his teaching.
不易与罔顾神和他的教导是有关系的。
Fornication and cohabitation is lawlessness because the Bible teaches this as unacceptable.
通奸和同居是不义的，因为圣经教导这些是不被接受的。
The marriage bed must not be defiled, and our bodies were brought with the blood of Jesus Christ.
婚床不可被玷污，我们的身体是用耶稣基督的宝血买来的。
In future, there will be challenges in regards to how they view the definition of marriage.Roles, responsibilities, and expectation, handling finances, raising children in the ways of the Lord, and God being the priority in our lives.
在未来，如何看待婚姻的定义、角色、责任、期望、处理财务、用神的方式抚养孩子、让神在生命当中成为最优先的等等，都可能会成为冲突点。
Of course, even if you have a Christian boyfriend or girlfriend, we should take time to observe the person's character in order before we make that decision.
当然了，即使你的另一半是一位基督徒，我们也应该去看一下他的属灵的成熟程度，或者是他的呼召和品格把这些考虑在内。
Likewise, at the same time, if you are married to a Christian,
那么同时呢，如果您是与另一位基督徒就是在一个婚姻里
，and both of you are seeking the face of God,
那么同时你们在寻求神的面。
The Bible tells us to live and cleave to our wives.
那么就是在圣经当中要告诉我，让我们去更加紧密的相合。
We are one flesh with our spouse.
因为我们与我们的另一半是同一个肉体。
So when you pray and seek the face of God.
当你在祷告并寻求神的面的时候。
And let's say your husband feel that I'm supposed to go to London.
比如说你的丈夫可能会觉得我们家庭要么搬到伦敦吧。
I have a posting in London.
公司派我去伦敦。
And you feel that I have a career in Shanghai.
但是你作为妻子，你就会说没有啊，我在上海有职场。
I don't want to go to London.
我不想去伦敦。
I want to be Shanghai. You can be in London. I will be in Shanghai.
你可以告诉你的，那你丈夫你去伦敦，我在上海吧。
There's a separation.
那么这个就是两个人之间的分离。
That's not God's will.
这个并不是神的旨意。
And when you are apart.
And
when things happen,
那么如果有一些挑战的事情发生,
God is not to be blamed.
那这个就不能够指责神了。
It is the work of the flesh.
因为这个就是我们用情欲、肉体做的
决定。You have made your own decision.
我们用自己的意志去做出的决
定。Because the Bible said to live and cleave as one flesh.
因为在圣经当中告诉我，这夫妻成为一体。
Christianity, the marriage in the Christian view is, it is.Being one flesh.
在婚姻在基督教的意思就是男女结合为一体。
It's not two strong individuals living under the same roof sharing the same bed.
并不是说在同一个屋檐下有两个有非常自我强意志的人生活在一起。
It is not a contractual marriage.
这个并不是一个合约的婚姻。
It is a covenant marriage.
这是一个盟约的婚姻。
No, when you have your values right.And your identity is in Christ.
在你是深深的扎根在耶稣基督的自己的一个认知，自我
的认知。Both of you will pray together.
那么你和你的另一半会同时一同祷告。
Both of you will go together.
你们也会往同一个方向走。
And then when you have children,
当你们有了孩子之后
you will decide who will stay, who will give up the job and look after the children.
你们会两个人同时决定会谁是抛弃工作来去
照顾孩子。Your values will be very different.
你们的价值观不一样。
Amen. Oh, Pastor, very difficult.
你可能牧师，这个事情太难了。
He has his career.
他有我的丈夫有。
I also want my career.
有他自己的职场，我也有自己的职业生涯。
So where's the children going to stay? London or Shanghai?
所以我们应该要去伦敦呢，还是要在上海呢
？Is the children more or the children just outsource to IE?
我们把我们的孩子可以外包给阿姨去照顾。
Then your children will have the 阿姨's value.
那么你的孩子就是有阿姨的价值观了。
Who is to blame?
这该指责谁呢
？Who is to blame if your children have no relationship with you?
如果你的孩子与你没有一个深刻的一个关系的话，那这该去指责谁呢
？God is not to blame.
这个肯定不能是指责于神。
Because the operating manual is very clear.
因为我们的指导思想是非常清楚的。
God will not tell you to do things that's completely different from what His Word advocates.
因为神不会告诉你我们与圣经完全相悖的事情。
Amen. So it's a matter of whether you want to seek the face of God, whether you want to abide with what the Word of God teaches.
所以重要的是我们是否是会在寻求神的面，能不能够行在神的旨意里。
So don't do anything unless you have God's blessing.
所以呢，你不要做任何事情，直到你得到神的祝福。
Galatians 2:20 says, "I have been crucified with Christ; is I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life that I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave Himself for me."
我已经与基督同钉十字架，现在活的不再是我，乃是基督里。基督在我里面活着，并且我如今在肉身活着，是因信神的儿子而活。他是爱我，为我舍己。
We are to live a consecrated life.
所以我们要过的是成圣的生命。
Consecrated in the way where we seek His will to and His plan for our lives.
那么成圣就表示的是我们要寻求他的面，并且行出他的旨意。
Consecration also means to walk in holiness and godliness.
也就是说，成圣是我们要走在圣洁的道路上。
So in verse 12 and verse 15 of the main text says, "And Moses said to Moses, 'See, you say to me, bring up these people, but you have not let me know whom you will send me with me. Yet you have said, I know you by name. You have also found grace in my sight. Now therefore, I pray, if I found grace in your sight, show me now your way that I may know you, that I may find grace in your sight. And consider this nation is your people.' And he said, 'My presence will go with you. I will give you rest.' Then he said to him, 'If your presence does not go with us, do not bring us from here.'"
出埃及记的，我们回看一下十二节到十五节。摩西对耶和华说：“你吩咐我说，你将这百姓领上去，却没有叫我知道你要打发谁与我同去，只说我按你的名认识你，你在我眼前蒙了恩。我如今若在你眼前蒙恩，求你将你的道指示我，使我可以认识你，好在你眼前蒙恩。求你想到这民是你的民。”耶和华说：“我必亲自和你同去，使得你安息。”摩西说：“你若不亲自和我同去，我就不要把我们从这里领上去。”
Moses was a wise leader. He said, Moses said, unless your presence go with us, you God, you literally go with us, do not send us where you want us to go.
因为摩西说了，你若不亲自和我同去，就不要把我们从这里领上去。
I don't want an angel to go with us. I want you to go with us.
我要你的天使和我同去，我要你和我同去。
You are a leader of your life.
你呢，就是你的人生当
中的主宰。You are a leader of your family.
主宰和你的家庭当
中的领袖。You must be the wise leader.
所以你需要成为一个睿智的领袖。
The wise leader said, God, not my will be done, but your will be done in my life.
因为睿智的领袖就会说，不是要我的旨意，而是要神你的旨意。
John 15:7 says, "If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it will be done for you."
约翰福音十五章七节讲到，你若常在我里面，我的话也常在你们里面。凡你们所愿意的，祈求就给你们成就。
Abiding in God means abiding in His word.
常在神里面的意思就是常在神的话语里面。
Abiding in what His word teaches us.
也就是我们常在接受神的话语对我们的教导。
Choosing to do His will for our life rather than choosing what we want to do.
也就是选择神要我们所做的生命当中的事情，而不是我们自己的意志。
So sometimes when your prayer is not answered.
那么有时呢，你的祷告好像没有被应允。
You have to ask yourself.
你要问自己。
Are you doing what you want to do, or are you doing what God wants you to do?
你要问自己的是，你去寻求的是你要自己的主意呢，还是神的主意呢
？Why?
为什么
？Because 1 John 5:14-15 tells us, now this is the confidence. Many of us like words like this, confidence, right? That we have in Him. If we ask anything according to His will, He hears us.And we know that He hears us. Whatever we ask, we know that we have the petition that we have asked of Him.
约翰一书五章十四到十五节，我们若照着他的旨意求什么，他就听我们。这就是我们向他所存坦然无惧的心。既然知道他听我们一切所求的，就知道我们所求于他的无不得着。
So when we are walking with God.
我们在与神同行的时候
you will pray.
我们就会祷告
you will say, Your will be done in my life, Lord.
我们会经常说主啊让你的旨意行在我的人生当中
you will pray the prayer of consecration.
我们也会去祷告成圣的祷告
So what is the prayer of consecration?
那么什么是一个这个圣的分别为圣的祷告呢
It is praying about the will of God for your life.
那么也就是让神为中心的祷告
Submitting yourself to God's will.
也就是顺服神的旨意
You can pray this prayer repeatedly until the will of God is known.
一个你可以反复诵祷的一个祷告，直到你知道神的旨意为止。
We're in the first week of 2024.
那么我们现在是在2024年的第一周。
You might be at a fork road of your life.
有可能您在您人生的岔路上。
Turn left, turn right, or stay still.
我们往左走，往右走，还是在原地回流呢
？Let us be like Moses.
我们让我们越来越像摩西一
样。Lord, do not send me anywhere.
不要把我派到什么地方
unless your presence go with me
除非你亲自和我与同去
I will not go anywhere unless you speak to me
我不会去哪里直到你向我说话为止
I will not start a business unless you tell me to start a business
我不会开启一个新的生意直到你向我说话为止
I will not migrate to a country unless you tell me to migrate to a country
我不会移民到另外一个国家直到你向我说为止
Let me seek your face, even if it's internal posting within a big company.
即使是公司内部的职位的转换，我也要寻求你的面。
Let us not go anywhere unless the presence of God goes with us.
我们请我们站立原地，直到神向我们说话
为止。Let us be like that.
让我们就像摩西一样。
Let me invite Leslie to come forward to give us his testimony.
我想请 Leslie 弟兄上台与我们分享一下他的见证。
Pastor Daniel said he knew a lot of stiff-necked people. I just want to say I'm one of them.
我想因为刚才Daniel 牧师也分享了这个硬着颈项的百姓，其实呢，我是其中一位。
Four years ago, I still remember very clearly that I fell into a pit like Joseph did. Right? I wanted something more for my career and where I was going in life. I wanted it very badly.
四年前呢，我感觉到我像约瑟一样掉到了一个无底洞。我想要得到什么，但一直没有得到一个满足。
In that time, one thing I think I was wise enough to listen from this pulpit, and therefore I hope that you'll be listening today's message very, very carefully. I decided to give God the first of everything that I had, despite of where I was.
我当时我觉得做的一个比较正确的事，也想与大家一个分享的是，当时我决定是把我所有的东西都奉献于神。
God was saying to me at that time very harsh words. He said, "Why are you stealing from me? And why do you give me your second-hand time?"
神当时与我讲了非常严斥的斥责我说，为什么你从我这里偷东西盗窃？第二是为什么你没有把我你没有把你的优先的时间奉献于我
？So I got my finances in order.And I took a decision of the spiritual leader of the house to tithe, not my wife. I do it. I used to make her do it, and sometimes she would do it, not do it, but I do it. The second thing I did was I get up every morning and I pray and I read scripture. And I've done that consistently unless I was on traveling for about 4 years now. Yeah.
我做了两件事情。第一呢，是我梳理了一下我的家庭的财政情况。我原来呢是让我的妻子去做的十一奉献和每周的奉献，但呢，我作为家庭的领导领袖，我就打算自己去做这个奉献。第二呢，就是我早上起来的第一件事情就是去诵读圣经，并且向他祷告。
Now it sounds very easy.I tell you, those few years were extremely painful because the soul, and the Bible talks about the heart, was intrinsically wicked and very proud, right? I journal every day, like Pastor was saying, please journal. So I have an app that I record every day. And a number of days, you can see how frustrated I was with God. Where am I going? Where's this new job, promotion? Whatever you talk about, that I wanted something so badly.And I said, God, have you forgotten me? Or has my employer forgotten me?
但两件事情听起来容易，但是我那几年的生活是非常的枯竭的。当时经文也讲到我们的心是非常悖逆的一个心。我每日其实都会记入我的日记，在那段的日记翻看回看来看，写的都是我那么渴望得到的一个东西而没有得到，所以我就会质问神：神，您忘记我了吗？还是说我的公司忘记了我呢？
So 2 years into that season, I remember my wife sending me a note one day and say, this is for you, I think. Deuteronomy 4:22. I remember that verse because I journal, and that's what the point of journaling is. Yeah.
当时两年前左右呢，我的妻子给我发了一段经文，她说丈夫，这个是好像是为你所准备的经文。当时我记得呢，是一个《生命记》4:22的经文。
And if you remember what it means, it was Joshua, right? He was given an instruction: take the tribes of Israel across to the other side, right, to the promised land. I thought, oh God, yes, fantastic! This is the season when you're going to get me something new, right? You jump to that conclusion straight away, yeah.
这个约书亚就是《生命记》4:22，如果大家记得的话，就是在讲约书亚，他是在讲经过约旦河之后进入应许之地的那段经文。所以当时我非常的兴奋，说：“神，你是现在要让我进入应许之地了，感谢你。
”But God had other plans. He closed every door.
但是呢，神的计划确实是不一样的，他关闭了所有的一些可能性。
See, God has a higher purpose, doesn't he, for your life? And he closed every door, and I got even more frustrated. And then one day, my wife said, hey, you want some feedback?
神，你记得是在我们人生当中有更高的目标的。所以我当时因为失去了更多机会之后，就会感到更加疲惫。然后我的妻子就会说，我想给你一个反馈。
I tell you, and I said, not really. I don't want any feedback from you.
然后我当时就说，不好意思，我不太想听你的反馈。
She actually said, if you look at your qualifications, you need to go back to business school.
当时她所我的妻子告诉的我的是，你看一下你的这个过去的资历，其实你更需要的是去读一个商学院。
I'm not a young fellow, you know.
我现在不年轻了。
But I realized one thing, men, you got to understand this.Your family, husband and wife, you are the two out of the three that God listens to when you pray in agreement. That's very, very powerful. And I humbled myself to listen to a person that I actually least likely to want to hear. right? Because we've got our pride as a guy in the household, and here comes your wife saying, "Got feedback for you," right?
我想与大与尤其对与兄弟分享这件事情，我们经常是在家庭当中有两位，也就是丈夫和夫妻子作为合为一体向神祷告那么经常呢我们作为男人会有很多的傲娇，也不愿意去听妻子对你的反馈。
The short story was God actually led me to business school here in Shanghai.And it's quite interesting because the moment my wife gave me feedback, there was something in our hearts that just leapt. And we say, I think the atmosphere of faith moved in our home. Because now we know exactly what God wants, and I was going to step into His will. Long story short, I got into that university and I was the easiest customer for them because I called them up and say, when do I apply? And the guy says, don't you even want to come and see us? I said, no, when do I sign up? And that was it.
当时就是我们去考虑要读商学院的时候呢，我心中，我妻子对我讲了这句话之后，我的心中有一个非常强的感动。那么从此之后，我们家庭的属灵的生活也到了一个新的高度。我非常庆幸的是打电话给一个我想去的商学院，就去询问我如何去申请。但是呢，我非常庆幸的是那个学校也比较容易的去接受了我。
Remember what Pastor Daniel always says, if it's God's will, he pays.
你记得我们的牧师会经常讲到，如果是神的旨意的话，那么神会买单的。
I'm an old fella, I was probably the oldest in my class, right? So I go in there and I applied for a scholarship, and my wife was laughing, said, I don't think you ever get that. But I got it.
我在我的班里呢，其实是年龄最大的一个但是我鼓起勇气去申请了奖学金。当时我的妻子也这个取笑我说，来你去申请试试看吧。但是非常感谢的是，我得到了这个奖学金。
But you know that's not what the point was. You know, you think that God says, "Ah, okay, Leslie, give you a break now because He's going to give you some intellectual knowledge at a business school." But I went there on the first day. I say, "God, what do you want me to do?"
大家可能会想，我在商学院得到的是一种商业界的知识，那么我就是在去上学的第一天去寻求了神的面，神，你要我在这里做什么呢？
And it's interesting, I was able to declare my faith and my love in Jesus to as many classmates as wanted to listen to me. And I met a few people that came up and say, I have to speak to you. And I gave them counsel and told them about Jesus. So God has a higher purpose.But you see, if you seek His kingdom first, He adds all these other things that you need and want in this world. But you've got to get the equation right. God first, your family, and then everything else added onto it.
那么非常感谢的是我能够从此至今与诸多的同学分享我多么的爱上帝和神在我里面所做的各种奇迹和见证。也有很多同学要找到我来说，我想与你谈话，我想认识那一位神。所以我想与大家分享的是，神在我们人生当中有更高的目标，我们应该不要去忘记神在我们树立人生当中树立的优先次序，就是神第一，家庭第二，和职场第三。
I know now that I was tested by God for the last 4 years of my life. I kept failing, and finally maybe I passed, but I'm still failing. But God is a God that allows you to retest, right? And I think I've come to a point now where I can give God the glory, and I know that in this season of growth now for me, the best is yet to come.
在过去四年当中我确实我现在明白是接受了神的试探但是我也感谢神，我经过了这段时间之后得到了成长，然后并且在我未来的生涯当中可能是一个新的开始。
Thanks Leslie. Proverbs 16:3 and verse 9 says, commit your works to the Lord and your thoughts will be established. A man's heart plans his way, but the Lord directs his steps.
在箴言的十六章三到九节所讲，你所做的要交托耶和华，你 所谋的就必成立。人心筹算自己的道路，
所以耶和华指引他的脚步。
那么如何该使用这个本子呢？
It's very self-explanatory.
其实是比较容易去读的。
You write down the date.
把日期记下来。
Write down the six chapters that you're reading.
那么也可以把你现在所诵读的六章的圣经
写下来。Pray and ask God to speak to you primarily through the word.
那么祷告并祈求上帝首先借着圣经对你
说话。Don't have a preconceived answer to your prayer.
请大家不要有任何自己所想要的答案来去祷告。
Commit your ways to the Lord.
你把自己的道路交给神。
The Lord tells us that.My sheep will hear my voice.
因为神告诉我们，我的羊会听我的话。
And God will speak to you very clearly for husband and wife too.
因为神也会非常清楚的对你说话。
And you will know a book, chapter, and verse that God has spoken to you.
我们也会知道圣经当中哪个章节、哪个经文向我们说话。
Why is it important to have the book and chapter and verse?
为什么这么这读圣经这么重要呢？
The Bible tells us that faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
我们在圣经当中所读到的是信是眼所见之事的实底和未见之事的确据。
What gives substance to your faith is the word of God.
那么我们信心之底就是来自于神的话语。
The word of God anchor your faith.
那么就是神的话语成为我们坚实的基底。
Now Jesus also prayed for the Lord's for the Father's will to be done in his life.
那么同样，耶稣基督当时也寻求神的旨意行在他的生活当中。
He was praying for the will of the Father in the Garden of Gethsemane.
因为大家记得吗？是在客西马尼园，他在跪下来向神祷告。
He said, "Not my will be done, Lord."
并不是我的意思
But your will be done.
而愿你的旨意成
全。He prayed three times the same prayer.
他是祷告了同样的祷告
三次。And when he got the answer from the Father that the only way is the way of Golgotha.
也就是说神耶稣基督得到的旨意就是被钉在十字架而死。
He submitted to the Father's will.
他顺服了神的旨意。
Likewise.
那么同样。
When we pray the prayer of consecration.
当我们做分别为圣的祷告的时候。
You can pray the same prayer.
我们可以同样的祷告。
For a month.
为一个月的祷告。
And say, Lord, unless you speak to me, I'm not going to act.
除非你向我说话，我不会去行动。
And then when God speaks,
当神对你讲话的时候
you act.
那你就可以去行动。
But when God is silent,
那么当神去静默的时候
the last instruction stand.
那也就是最后的一个旨意也是可行的。
The second thing that you need is to be sensitive to the leading witness of the Holy Spirit.
那么第二个大家所要做的是敏锐于圣灵的引导和见证。
Romans chapter 4 verse 14 to 16 Romans chapter 8 verse 14 to 16 say, For as many are led by the Spirit of God, these are the sons of God. For you did not receive the spirit of bondage to fear, but you received the spirit of adoption by whom we cry, Abba Father. The Spirit himself bear witness with our spirit that we are children of God.
罗马书八章十四到十六节，因为凡被神的灵引导的，都是神的儿子。你们所受的不是奴仆的心，仍旧害怕；所受的是乃是儿子的心。因此我们呼叫阿爸父。圣灵与我们的心同证，我们是神的儿女。
So after you have received a word,
当你去接受神的话语之后
，pray through the decision.
那么你就应该为你的决定所
祷告。Check whether there's a peace in your heart.
来去审视在我们的心中是否有一个平安。
Sometimes when you make a decision that is not of God,
如果你做了一个决定不是按照神的旨意
做的话 there will be any peace in your heart.
那么我们的心中就会忐忑不安。
There's a discomfort.
这个就是会让我们感觉很不舒服。
There's like a red light in your heart.
可能在心中的红绿灯亮起了一个红灯。
That is, don't do it.
那么就不要做这个
事情。Many of us has crossed the red line.
那么很常常呢，我们有很多人去跨越了红线。
So that the four safeguards.
有四个保护措施。
The word of God.
第一呢，就是神的话语。
In your journal.
就是在我们每日的经文里。
Inner witness of the Holy Spirit.
也就是我们心底里圣灵的见证。
The third safeguard is godly counsel.
也就是第三个呢，就是这个敬虔的忠告。
Proverbs 15:22 says, "Without counsel, plans go awry, but in the multitude of counselors, they are established."
箴言的十五章二十二节所讲到，不先商议，所谋无效；谋事众多，所谋乃成。
So you can look for your pastor, your cell leader to journey with you.
所以你可以找到牧师，也可以找到细胞小组的领袖来。
Share with them, say, "I have been journaling."
然后你会告诉我，我说我又在读圣经，并且记录他的话。
I feel that God is speaking to me from this scripture.
我觉得是神通过这段经文来告诉我，
来向我
说话。那么你觉得是什么样呢？
Let me tell you.
我想告诉大家。
It is important to belong to a church.
是一个你应该归属于一个教会。
Go to a church where the pastor get to know you.And you get to know the pastor.
而且去这个教会呢，要认识当地的牧师，让牧师也来认识你。
Because there's protection for you.
因为这个就是对你的一个保护。
You know, just example.
举个例子。
I know of church members who like to change job every other year.
我认识一些弟兄姊妹是喜欢每一年都要换一次工作的。
So when they come and see me.
所以他可能会找到我。
Of course, I'll pray with them.
我会向他们一同祷告。
But sometimes I tell them, I think it is not God.
然后我会直接告诉他们说，这个好像不是神的旨意。
So there's protection in a multitude of counsels.
所以呢，在敬虔的忠告里面也有多重层次的
一个保障
措施。最后
，Don't be stiff-necked.
不要成为硬着颈项的百姓。
You to God.
那么要顺服神。
Submit to God.
要重新的顺服神。
Tell the Lord.
告诉神说
，Not my will be done.
不是按照我的旨意
But your will be done in my life.
而你的旨意行在我的人生中
Do not lead us to lead me to a place where your presence will not go with me.
如果你不亲自与我同去，我就不会去那里
Speak to me personally.
请你对我说话
Have an inner witness of the Holy Spirit.
让我们得到内心的圣灵的见证
Have a godly counsel.
然后会有敬虔的圣灵当中的
If God speaks to you to go.
忠告，然后神如果告诉我
Step out in faith.
去的话，那么我就要用信心来去执行计划。
Stay focused on God.
那么就要专注于神。
Do not be moved by the circumstances.
不要因环境而动摇。
Focus on God.
去专注于神。
Spend quality time with God.
然后与神有一个深入的交流。
He will continue to advise you.
他会持续的引导你。
He will give you the strategy.
他也会给你战略。
And if God say no.
那么神如果说不的话。
Be humble enough to accept it.
那么心里要谦虚并接受。
Let's bow our head and pray.
让我们低头一起祷告。
With every head bow and every eyes closed.
当我们去低头闭眼一同祷告时。
I'd like to ask a very critical question this morning.
我想问一个非常重要的问题。
If you are here with us this morning.
如果在座的各位。
You are not a Christian.
如果您还不是一位基督徒。
You have never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
您从来没有接受过耶稣基督
为你的救主。But you'd like to receive Jesus Christ today.
但是你今天想要接受他。
I'd like to pray with you.
我想与你一同祷告。
If that's you.
如果那是你的话
we just raise your hand,
请你举起你的手
raise your right hand and put it down.
请你举起你的右手然后
Thank you, I see your hand, anybody else?
谢谢你的手
Just raise it higher so that I can see you.
请大家举得高一些让我能够看见
Okay, thank you, I can see your hand.
谢谢你
For those of you who have raised your hand,
举起手的兄弟姊妹们
Will you say this prayer with me?
请你与我一同祷告吧
Because the Bible says
因为圣经说
When we believe in our hearts and confess with our mouth
如果我们心里相信并且口里承认
We will be saved
我们就会得到救恩
We will be a children of the living God
我们就会成为活神的儿女
So say this prayer with me
所以请你与我一同祷告
Say dear Heavenly Father
亲爱的天父
Thank you for sending Jesus to die for me on the cross
谢谢你派耶稣基督到这个世上在十字架留下宝血而死
Forgive me of my sin
请你饶恕我的罪
I'm a sinner
因为我是个罪人
Come into my heart today
请你进入我的心
Be my Lord and Savior
成为主和救主
Lead me and guide me in my life
请你引导我的人生
In Jesus name I pray
以耶稣基督
Amen
而名祷告
Let's welcome them Praise the Lord Let me pray for the rest of you
我想为其他的兄弟姊妹一同祷告
Father, I pray for my brothers and sisters in Christ
天父我为我的弟兄姊妹而祷告
That they will commit to seeking your face every day of their lives
让他们每日能够寻求你的面
I pray that Father they will not seek you during a time of hardship but they will seek you on a daily basis
并不是他们遇到挑战时才寻求你的面而是在每日的生活当中都寻求你
May they read your word and be led by the Spirit
让他们能够每日诵读你的话语能够用圣灵被引导
And I pray that Lord, you will be with them.
我也祷告您与他们同在。
Now may the love of the Father,
天父的慈爱
the grace of Lord Jesus Christ,
以耶稣基督的恩典
and the fellowship of Holy Spirit,
和圣灵的感动与交通
be with you,
与你同在
now and forevermore.
从今直到永远。
Amen.